Decime, ¿no? Okay, perfect. So hi all. So my name, as Desi said, is Santiago Belda. So mainly I developed the toolbox called DATimeS. No, this toolbox is a new toolbox. It's not new now because it was developed 2 years ago. But we try to continue developing new things in DATimeS. No, so. So the title of my talk, no, is about the is DATimeS, a new toolbox for time series analysis opportunities for Sentinels time series processing. So as you know, the DATimeS is basically based in three modules. No, the first one is based on the gap filling due to clogs in the images, gaps, and so on. The second module is based on the phenological indicators estimation. And the third module is based on the synergy between different sensors, satellites, and or different data sets. So these three modules, okay, compose DATimeS. So I would like to say that DATimeS works in different formats for the images in TIFF or MV format, or as well, if you want, you can work in a single pixel, in a single wise pixel. If you have some ticketist file, as you can see here, no? If you have your data in one pixel, you can also use that. But the powerful thing for DATimeS also is in the image format. No, you can process big images with too many pixels as well, and so on. So after that, you also with DATimeS create some nice videos, animations, and especially you can do some spatial interpolation to have nice plots, figures, and so on. This is more or less some tools and some overview that is important to know for DATimeS. So first of all, I'm going to start to speaking about the gap filling module. Okay, this gap filling module. What is the goal of this module? So the goal is to reproduce continuous fields in time in space from discontinuous data. Due to, as you can see here in this video, no, we have some problems with the satellite data due to clogs or problems with the sensors. Due to these problems, we have gaps in the images. For that reason, we need to know what is the best gap filling algorithm or technique in order to use to reproduce to retrieve all this information that would be useful in later further for the phenological indicator estimation. And here in this image, you can see the performance, for example, of one of the mean of all these pixels for different years, no, after we did this gap filling. And you can see how it is the performance. We can see some seasonalities in the different years and so on. So DATimeS provide different gap filling techniques and methods. The first one, we provide the conventional and typical harmonic methods. No, for example, the Fourier analysis using different approaches, including the linear trends or quadratic terms, and also some approach, some sliding window approach using also this harmonic or Fourier techniques. So also the users can use the double logistic functions, that these functions are also good to estimate the phenological indicators, but they are widely used in the scientist community for this phenological estimation, but also we can use that for the gap filling. And also we provide the Whittaker smoother. This technique, for me, I like a lot because it's very fast and very good for this gap filling, and it's really fast. So I recommend you, if you would use DATimeS, try first with the Whittaker. So it's very good. And later we provide the conventional MATLAB methods, okay, for this gap filling. Probably these techniques are not the best one, but it's only to test, no, for the users can play with it more methods. So I forgot to say that DATimeS is programmed in MATLAB, but also the users can use DATimeS as a standalone version. So you don't need to use MATLAB for use DATimes. You only so you can install your program DATimes in a Windows operating system. And also the most important powerful part of DATimes for this gap filling is that we provide too many different machine learning algorithms to do this gap filling. For example, we provide too many, but I would like to highlight the GPR and the Gaussian process regression and the kernel regression. I think these two techniques are the most powerful techniques, basically GPR, because we also, after this gap filling, we also can have some uncertainty estimation of the quality of this gap filling as well. So now in this slide, so in this picture, you can see, okay, some pixel, okay, the pixel values that we take for the satellite data, this is the black line. So, but we have too many gaps. So in using different techniques, the gap filling, we can recover in the best way, the gap filling when we have gaps. For example, in this example, we do the gap filling every 10 days, for example, and we can recover this information for one pixel, but for too many pixels at the same time for big images as well. So this is one example. In this case, we have two seasonalities. So in this example, for example, we have too many seasons, a long time series, for example, using Landsat because we have more data, but okay, with different techniques. So you can see here, and all it's important to note that the GPR, the Gaussian process regression, is the red line, but also the shadow red color is the uncertainty estimation of this gap filling. So this is also important to know. So after that, for example, if we use the pixel-wise gap filling analysis, also in DATimes, we can store this information for a single pixel in a ticketing file with the different gap filling values, okay, with the different techniques. So this is also useful if you want to use this information for further analysis or studies. So later in DATimes, we provide some statistical errors after this gap filling in order to know what is the best technique as well. So the typical conventional errors, we estimated the root mean square error, the R squared, so and so on. So this is how looks like the gap filling model of DATimes. So first of all, we have the option to input the input to insert single pixels or images in TIFF or MB format. After that, we can mask if we know more or less the values or some values that so in order to mask the cloud value. So if you insert some data, some values here, the pixels between these values will be excluded from your analysis and will be considered as a cloud and will be recovered information after the gap filling. Later, we can use some mask as well if you only want to focus in a specific crops or area or regions. You can select the different band. If you are using images, you can select the different bands you are interested to analyze. And also, you can also create an external mask for specific regions as well. So, and later, this is the different techniques for the gap filling we provide. Here you can see, you can select at the same time too many techniques to try, okay? But if you select too many techniques at the same time, probably the time consuming will be bigger. So I recommend you to try first two or three at the same time, no more, because probably will take too much time. So later we provide, we additionally provide some smoothing techniques as well. Okay, I don't remember if before or after the gap filling, but also to try to have the best to remove the noise data, because sometimes the data are too noisy and we need to reduce this this noise from the time series as well. And also for the gap filling, we have different options that we can do the gap filling every specific days, for example, every 10 days, or you can use some vector that in order to recover specific days that you indicate in one file, or you only want to do the gap filling only when we have gaps or clouds. And this is more or less how looks like the previous slide, the overview of the gap filling module. But the next module that DATimeS provide is the is based on the phenological indicator parameters. So the goal of this module is to study of recurring patterns of vegetation growth and development, as well their connection to climate. Now, in agriculture studies, they could be very useful in order to be more efficient with the water and with the timing, when we need to go to the field and so on. In this image, you can see how is the performance of the different seasonalities for one specific crop for different years. And it's remarkable that these seasonalities are not the same every year. It means that every year changes. So we need to catch, to try to understand what is the reason of this variability, or try to modulate in the best way possible these variations as well. So this is an example if the people don't know what the phenological parameters are. So in this case, I'm going to explain. So first of all, the start and with DATimeS, we can estimate the start and end of the season, before and after. Okay, later we can estimate also the length of the season, so the duration between the end and the start of the season, as well we provide the base value, the middle of the season or the seasonality, and the maximum value. We provide the amplitude and as well the areas. This value of the areas sometimes are really important, because we could try to use these area values in order to relate with the yield or productivity of the specific crops. So I think we provide different phenological indicators that probably could be useful for your studies or scientific for your investigations. So now, as in the previous module, I show you how it looks like this module. So is the first part is similar, is identically the same that the gap filling module, but now here we have the different phenological indicators that we can estimate in DATimeS. You can select or unselect the parameters you want, but I recommend that select all, because the time consuming is the same. So later you can previously smooth your results or not, but you also you can use the gap filling results that you, and also you can use the results that you get, that you got in the previous module for the gap filling. So it's all connecting. And later we can play with these values of the prominence. The people don't know the prominence. This value is really sensitive to try to catch the different seasons in different years, because sometimes if the data are too noisy, if this value is very small, probably we can detect more seasons that probably are happened in the reality. So probably this value is very sensitive, so we have to take care about if you use this value, you have to play a little bit in order to know what will be the best parameter for your case study. And also we provide different techniques to estimate the phenological indicators. For example, the seasonal amplitude, the relative amplitude, and the absolute amplitude. If you want to know more about these different techniques, so I recommend you to go to the manual, to the manual of DATimeS, and also the paper of DATimeS, that is well explained there, the different which technique are with a nice explanation about that. So, and after that, I would like to explain the third module. Okay, this third module is useful to do synergy, the synergy between different sensors. And why we provide that? Because This is important because sometimes, you know, with Sentinel-2 is optical data, we have the problems of the close gap filling, gaps, and so on. But if we use Sentinel-1 radar, so radar, we don't have this problem with the clouds. So we can use the powerful of the radar mixing and doing the synergy with the Sentinel-2. So this is, and nowadays with the Sentinel missions, so it's very nice if we can mix or combine these different sensors in order to do this retrieval or better and with more accuracy. So this is more or less the goal of this model. So as I told you, no, the synergy, so using, for example, Sentinel-1 radar vegetation index and Sentinel-2 leaf area index, two different biophysical indicators or parameters, so we can take profit of this synergy module. So this synergy module is based on the multi-output Gaussian process regression to establish this synergy, no? So this technique is very powerful, but at the same time, so takes too much time to estimate, to do this synergy if your images are too big. And there are, so this is the main problem of this module, probably is the time consuming, no? So, but if you are playing with a small area, it will be no problem. But if you want to use more, your analyze bigger images, probably you need a very good computer to do that. So in this image, I'm going to show you the powerful of this synergy, no? For example, in this figure, in the top of the figure, we use the time series. Okay, I show you the time series. Okay, for example, the black cross dots are the original data that we measure with the satellites. But the blue dots are data that I remove, okay, that I remove for the satellite data in order to know if the synergy improve or not improve, okay, and catch these seasonalities, because in this way, if we don't use the synergy and we use the simple Gaussian process regression, this seasonality, you can see here that is skipped, is not cannot be estimated, because we don't have enough data to try to catch this seasonality. However, if we use the synergy between different sensors, Sentinel-2 and Sentinel-1, you see that this seasonality that was skipped in the first case is can be catched and can be measured, and the quality of your data will be better. So this is the potential of using synergy. I hope it's clear, more or less. So, and also if we do some statistics as well, as you can see here, no, the R square always is better because we catch the seasonality, and the 2-mean square in comparison if you don't use the synergy. So this is another example that also is really nice, because if we use the synergy with different sensors, for example, Landsat 7, 8, and Sentinel 2, so is, as you know, Sentinel 2, the observation starts around 2018, more or less, but the observation of the Sentinel of the Landsat start in the around 2015. So I think in the previous years. So we don't have data in this part of the figure with the Sentinel-2, but using the multi-output Gaussian process regression, using this synergy between these different three satellites, we can retrieve this information for the past as well. So I think also this is another powerful thing that we have to highlight of using this synergy as well. So this is another example. For example, if we use four different sensors in this, okay, you can see here the different colors provide, it means that we are, so are different sensors. If we do this synergy, we can retrieve all this information for around, as you can see here, from the 83 until 2019 or 20, more or less. So this is basically the three modules. So this, the first one was the gut feeling. The second one was the vegetation phenological indicators module and the synergy module, the last one. In the future, we try to provide, for example, some new modules, for example, for the yield prediction or automatic harvest detection or disturbance detection as well. But this is not that done yet, but we try to develop in the next step. So now, as I told you, DATimeS has some documentation manual that could be useful for the users as well. So in this case, I'm going to show an example, okay, a real case with some data that, for example, using leaf area index, LAI, from a range from 2015 to 2019 of a region of Spain, in the north of Spain, Castilla-La Mancha, Castilla-León is called. So in this case, so we have different regions, but in this case, I'm going to focus in this region that I select in a blue color. So this is this region. In this case, we previously do the gap filling and later we estimate the phenological indicators, okay? Before gap filling and later and next the estimation of the phenological indicators. As you can see here, we at times provide different maps of these phenological indicators. So here we provide, you can see the start of the season, the end of the season. As you can see, the values are totally consistent because the start of the season start around, for example, in this case, around 40, 60, 80 even. But the end of the season, for example, is more or less around 180 days as well. So it's more or less consistent. We provide also the amplitude values of the leaf area index, when happens this maximum value, and also the maximum value, the value of this maximum, and also we provide the area. This area, as I told you, is really important to try to study the yield, the productivity of different crops as well. So in this case, I'm going to show the phenological metrics for different crops. For example, in this case, I select all these five different crops. So in the first figure, I show the barley crop, and you can see here that this is the performance when this is the behavior of this kind of crop of three different years. As you can see, this DATimeS can estimate, can catch only two seasons, not three. Why is the reason? Because the first season, we don't have enough data to try to retrieve this phenological indicator information. For that reason, if you need to retrieve this phenological information, you need to have more data from the past. This is the only requirement. But because it's not possible to do that if we don't have too much, if you have a few data. In this case, we retrieve only, we can catch estimate two seasons. For the case of the potato, in this case, we can estimate three seasonalities. We also estimate the start on end of the season, the area, and so on. Also, in the case for the beet, as you can see, if we compare with the different crops, the performance of the seasonalities are totally different. We can say that some crop has some specific behavior as well. So this is the case from the rape. The rape also has a specific performance as well. And we estimate three seasons. Seasonalities, and the last case is from the wheat. So also after you estimate these phenological indicators, you can create some nice tables, for example, like that. In this case, I create a table with the different crops and with the different seasons detected. And you can see here, these are the values for the different phenological parameters indicators. And so we can compare with the different years and the different crops, the different dates, and So, and this is important in order to study any relationship with the crop yield and weather as well. So we have to think about it. So finally, finally, we can say that DATimeS is user-friendly. Okay, so it's a standalone software. What it means that you don't need MATLAB to use DATimeS. You have to install in your computer. So DATimeS, if you have Windows operating system. So we can analyze different image format, MV or TIFF format. We provide different harmonic machine learning algorithms, a double simulated function, and we target to do this gap filling as well. So it could be useful to make a smart and timely decisions to improve yield and profit based on the right and accurate data. It could be useful also for sustainable crop production. As I told you, we plan in the future to develop new modules, automatic disturb, automatic harvest, and disturbance detection, and so on. So more or less, okay, this was my presentation for today. If you have any questions, so let me know. Okay, I will try to help you. So of course, of course, if you want to download to have this DATimeS toolbox, you have to go to a specific web page that is called Armo. Okay, in Armo you can download this. You have to log in, create a new user and password, and later you can download this toolbox as well. So thank you very much, and I hope you like it.